Because we have started the query, and in that we have done a lot of things, just like giving increment and check it out if salary is less than 25,000. So its text is going to be detected, or its text is going to be shown. Right now today we are going to go further and putting some more data in a query, and we'll discuss this query more. Okay, first of all I'm going to create one table of student is there, and along with that marks is available. So how this grade and fail and pass is created, how this grade, fail and pass are created, by the help of query they are going to be created, by the help of query they are possible to create. So I'm going to go over the student, open that here, student name is there, term, okay, program, comments, okay, these things are available. What I'm going to do furthermore, firstly entering the data, Masood Ahmad, and term K, DIT, term F, DIT. Okay, copy this one, control and paste, and comment fee also. I'm going to give here 12,000, or here just $50, $52, and $63, $50, and admission fee. Furthermore, so that is male female. Okay, this table has been saved. I'm going to add one more, two students, and then putting more here. Rashid, term K, DIT, and date of joining. Same, I'm going to enter. It will be, let's suppose, $50 and $160 for admission, and $200 for admission, and male, yes. Okay, right now what I'm going to do, I'm going to create a link with another table. How I'm going to do that? Control W, save changes. Here I'm going to create one more table by name of a result. Okay, by name of what? Result. Here go over to the create and table by design, and I'm going to, inside that we're going to enter the marks of the student. Okay, so result R underscore ID, result ID. Okay, or result ID. Come please. Yes. The type of this will be auto number, and here SID, it is a student ID. I'm going to check that it is a SID or registration student ID. Okay, so same field will be there in another table. Same field will be there in another table. Student ID. Okay, and it will be a number. It will be a number. Right now in another one, if you come over there, subject, which subject will be there, and text, last one is marks, and it will be a number. Okay, control W, save changes. Yes, done. This table name is going to be created result. Save changes. Yes. Okay, do you want to create any primary key? No, because okay, yes, automatically it will be created on result ID. Control W, done. Right now, if you're going to check it out, I want to enter data in a result. So separately, I don't want to enter. If I'm going to go over to the result table, double click. So you're going to enter student ID, subject, and how much marks he got. Okay, student ID, subject, and total marks. Student ID, subject, and total marks. Automatically, it's going to be entered. But another way is also there. If you come to the student table, I want that. Along with the student, automatically the subject and marks will show. So what I'm going to do, first of all, I'm going to create a relationship. How? Go over to the create, sorry, go over to the external data tools. In a tool, relationship is there? Yes. This was a previous one relationship, which was student and department, employees and department. I'm going to create another relationship, shows table. What was the table? Student. Add. And result also added. Two table has been inserted. Right now, what I'm going to do, I'm going to create a relationship here. The student ID is duplicated over here. So drag and drop. Student force integrity, yes, cascade update and cascade delete. Create one too many. One student can give three examination. One student can give four or five examinations. So one too many relationship has been created between student and result. Understand? Right now, control W save changes. Yes, done. Relationship has been saved also. Go over to the student table, and right now you can see that. If I'm going to clicking this plus sign, previously this plus sign was there?
No.
No. With the relationship, this plus sign was created. If I'm going to click on that, here subject operating system marks 85. Here subject computer application marks 70. Here subject graphic designing GD and marks 92. And introduction to computer I2C marks here 65. So you can see that the subjects are being entered for whom? For whom? For Jawad. For Jawad. Pressing this plus button and the result of Jawad has been hidden inside it. And furthermore, if I'm going to clicking this plus, so for RF you can enter the same results here. Subject. Okay, you can also apply lookup wizard with that. Look up wizard. Right now you can see the subjects are showing or not. This one, these four.
Yes,
I'm going to do that, that automatically the subjects will show. I'm going to do that, the subject will automatically show. So here I'm going to create one more table. Banamichi subjects. Banamichi subjects. Go over create table by design, and I'm going to create here a simple subject. And it will be text. Control W, save changes. SUBGCTS. Subjects. Enter that. No primary key. No. Because this is just text. Click on a subjects table and enter the subjects. Computer application. Here. Operating system. And graphic designing. And last one is introduction to computer.